Hello, welcome to LEV Toys. It's time to build a Lego Elves set today. We have got one that I haven't built yet. It's not a brand new one. There aren't any new ones for a few months yet, but it's okay. I've still got a few of the older ones left. So today let's build up the Lego Elves Elvendale School of Dragons. This one's got a couple of bags, big long sticky thing, and some stickers and some banners and a nice instruction book. So let's start by looking at the minifigure that comes in this set. Oh, look at those boots. Oh, look at those gunmetal grey pants. They're cool. Oh, I love his armoured sort of over-the-shouldery thing, and it's all got a scale pattern on it. This is Tidus Stormsurfer, the Water Elf. He is an exclusive mini doll to this set. So far, we haven't seen him in any other set. And he's got some awesome blue spiky hair with his little elf ears on there. And he is in charge of the Elvendale School of Dragons. The set also comes with a baby dragon, who we will meet in the second bag. But first up, Tidus needs the hourglass. The pink hourglass. It's very pretty. So he can tell the elves when they turn up how long they have got. Because when the time runs out on the hourglass, that's when the baby dragons, well, can't live anymore without their mothers once they've hatched. It's very tragic. So we need to actually build the School of Dragons so the elves have got somewhere to come to see Tidus to get information about the big dragons and the baby dragons. So much to do. So we'll build it. We've already started, which is good. Here we go, it's starting to take some decent shape now. We're building a little alcove down the bottom. There are a couple of hooks on either side where we're going to be putting little torches, little fire torches. Good, all right. And now we've got a wonderful archway. The alcove looks like an alcove. I very much love the designs of these Lego Elf sets. They're ornate and they're slightly fantastical, and the colours and the shapes and everything in them is just, they're just beautiful to look at as well as beautiful to build. Now we've built a little rivulet of water coming down, and there's a stone step going across it. There's another one leading up to it. Looks beautiful. And just next to the water is, I don't know what it is yet. Here's our first sticker. It looks like it might be a little step or a little seat on the side of something that might be a tree with that colour. There's a little stone archway. Oh, and a branch hiding a little alcove there. Another little archway, a little home. Maybe this is Miku's little home. Oh, I think it is. It's the perfect size for a baby dragon. That looks great. All right, and that is hidden at the base of a tree, which is next to our little rivulet of water, and with some stonework and, oh, it's just gorgeous. And some crystals on the front, of course, because this is Elvendale. Oh, I also like that little printed wood piece very, very much. Another little step or a little seat. Oh, sorry, Tidus, just knocked you off there. And I think there might be steps up to the second level. They're definitely dragon-sized steps, baby dragon-sized steps. Not adult dragon-sized steps, they're really, really big. And we've done well. Those two sides there with the tree and the other little archway are perfectly lined up. Ha! that's good. It means I've followed the instructions well. And they need a little bridge spanning that gap in the middle with some dragon footprints, some baby dragon footprints, tiny ones. That looks really great. There's a little box up there as well. I wonder what we're going to store in there. But back down the bottom, and here out the front of the little alcove is, I don't know yet because we're up to bag number two. And now we get to meet Miku, the baby dragon. Here he is, and he's just so pretty with his pink and his aqua blue. Ah, and he loves being here with Tidus, which is good because he's the only baby dragon, well, who has come to the dragon school so far. Poor Tidus. He made this whole dragon school. Oh, but look! See? Miku fits perfectly into his little hidey hole. I can't get him out again, though. And he's gone down the little stream. Whee! It is the perfect size for a baby dragon. And up the little steps. Oh, hold on. There we go, up the steps to the second level, across the bridgeway and into the box. Get out of the box. I'm sure we have to put something else in the box. But before we do that, we've still got a heap more building to do. So a lovely pink branch, because here in Elvendale, all of the foliage is pink and covered in gems. And down here on the front are some mushrooms, little toadstools. I don't think you fit in between them. They look really nice as ornamentation though. We'll find out what they're for soon, I'm sure. And in here on this little basket on the side is a letter, so that's his mailbox. And some flowers, of course. And it's looking good. Now this here has got my most favourite ornate piece there for a little desk by the look of it. And I like the pink see-through pieces as well. Those fuchsia see-through pieces, they make it just look really decorative. There's a cup on the top, and this is going to be a desk, definitely a desk. There's a quill feather for writing with, and on that little tabletop we're going to need a square with a sticker. So what is the sticker going to say? Oh, this is the information. So this is the page of the book that he brings up for the elves about, yeah, so when the baby dragon's eggs have hatched, they've only got the time on the timer to find their mothers, otherwise the baby dragons will perish. So let's put this timer over here on the table so we don't lose it. And we're going to install this little desk in the alcove on those little jumpers, which means we can pull it in and out, or we can turn it around. It's up to us where we want to put it. And if I try and take the hourglass off, I keep leaving bits of it behind. All right, we're done now. That looks absolutely marvellous. I really like that. There, so that's what it looks like from the front. And of course we can turn it around if we want to. So, up on the second level, and let's see what is going to go up here. If I can put these little hooks in the right place. There's one there. Biscuits in the box! Oh, they're cookies for the baby dragons! Oh, get out of there, Miku. Not yet. Move over. No cookies yet. In fact, we are going to put a lid on them with a giant cookie on it, so we know that is a box for cookies. I like that. That's very decorative. All right. These banners here with our dragons on them, they're going to go on the spots on the front, and they're held in with some crystals. They're excellent design feature. One on the other side, and I've just knocked the desk over. There we are. There, brilliant, looks fantastic. What is this? It's a little lamp. It's a little orange lamp, like a little bell, to hang over. Where is this going to go? Oh, to hang over the toadstools. So maybe it's a reading nook, or maybe it's their classroom. It's the baby dragon's classroom out the front. I bet it is. We will have to find out. And on top of the hook, we get another little sticker. It is the dragon school sticker. And that's not really very straight. I'm just going to see if I can get it any straighter. It's maybe the tiniest bit straighter. It'll have to do for now. I'll see if I can fix that up later. And all the way up to the top, we need a little point. And of course, we're going to need a couple of little kind of hinged winged pieces that fold in towards the point, because this is what we have on all of the buildings in Elvendale, and they look spectacular. So we've got one here. This is going to go on one side. And we need a mirror image of it for the other side. There we are. All right, let's install these. And then the facade, the outside front of the school will be complete. And we need to keep going on the second level. We got some more of this tree to continue up. And I can see a spot for another sticker. We'll put that on in a moment. And an interesting little hook out the side with a jewel on it. That's kind of weird hanging off there. It's going to have a function, I'm sure. And on here we've got a swirly arrow. And some more pink foliage with some gems and some flowers. Lovely. That's lovely. It's all very natural looking. And we have this big, long, brown, sticky thing. Bendy sticky thing, and we hinge it in there, and it's very springy. And maybe the baby dragons will have some fun just bouncing off that. But no, we need to build a little swing, kind of a swing, is that what we're going to call it? A swing that slides down it? Can you call a swing a slide? Because a swing should kind of swing, right? What do you call something that slides down that looks like a swing? A slide. Swing-lide. I don't know. This is it. Anyway, and Miku's going to have a go. Let's install it on our big brown bendy sticky thing. There we go. It just slides on. And then we need to curve it around and clip it in up at the back, at the top of the tree. There, very secure. So there's a little zip line. And whoop, it's very zippy. So if we let this go, we might turn Miku around so he's facing the right way. So if we let it go, slides straight down into the little stream of water. But it's supposed to help the dragons fly so they can get a bit of wind under their wings and then they can take off before they hit the bottom. There's also a little projectile, a little crossbow, but it is for shooting cookies! This will entice the baby dragons into the air to maybe take off and start flying and practice their flying while they're chasing after cookies. I think we have to try that out. So, come on, Miku. Let's see. Okay, let's try it out first. Yep, works incredibly well, as they always do. No, Miku, no cookie yet. You haven't actually done any flying. So, are we ready? We'll try again. And go! Oh, Mika's flown up and away. Where did you go? Where did that cookie go? Oh, you found it. Oh, really good job. Oops, rolling away. Quick. Rescue the cookie. Oh, well done. But we need to put that cookie back in the crossbow because we're not finished building yet. So sorry, Miku. I'll let you have a cookie later, I promise. Okay, one more part to build, and it has the biggest sticker of the lot on it. These are instructions for what the zipline's for. So it comes down and the dragons will take off from the bottom before it hits the stream. And there's a blackboard, oh, with chalk. And the other part there, let's put it on here. The other little pink thing with the white on the bottom must be the duster for cleaning the board off, the blackboard eraser, which I can't get off again. Good, so chalk and a blackboard eraser, and this comes over here next to the toadstools, which is the classroom. Oh, that's wonderful. So Miku can come, and he's the only, student. He needs to move closer. I think he might need glasses. Too close, a bit too close to the blackboard. Oh, let's bring some other baby dragons in so he's not so lonely. So Sparks here, and Rain, and Flora. Oh, that's good. Move over a bit so Flora can see. There we go! Now the school's full of baby dragons! Oh, I bet Tidus is absolutely thrilled. Can you all see? I think you can, but Miku's not looking the right way. Alright, it's playtime now, definitely playtime. So Miku is hiding in his little hidey hole, and all the other dragons are, come out and play, Miku, come out and play! So Miku's coming out to play! Aw, Miku and Rain are having a little splash in the stream, but where are Flora and Spark? They're up here plotting something, something cheeky. Watch out! Watch out down below! Oh, Spark, you cheeky dragon! Oh, but the other dragons thought it was hilarious. Okay, all right, they're flying off. Off you go, woo! Oh, oh! Okay, oh, because they're going up here to get into the cookie box! Goodness, all of these dragons are so cheeky! What's Flora doing? Okay, Flora, shoot the cookie! Ready, and go! Go, Spark! Go, Flora, who's gonna get the cookie? Who's got it? Oh, they both got it. Oh no, you've dropped it. Oh, Spark, you should not be knocking over Flora. Whoa, Rain just came in and, oh, and Miku just stole the cookie and, and there went Spark. Oh my goodness, they're as crazy as a box full of kittens. Oh dear. All right, now they're playing hide and seek and it looks like Flora is in. 3, 2, 1, ready or not, here I come. Okay, no need to kick over the hourglass. All right, so, not in the stream, not behind the toadstools, oh, behind the blackboard, found you, Spark, oh, Spark, all right, okay, all right, who's behind here, still looking for, oh, that was an easy one, oh, Rain, we found you, and can you see Miku, I don't think that Flora can. Flora's looking up here. No, not up here. Not up here. In the cookie box. Okay. Excellent. Hide and seek, baby dragons. Here, here's a cookie. Whoop. Oh, and they're all gone. My goodness, I don't envy Tidus having to look after these baby dragons all day. They're insane. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe and click like. Check out some of my other silly videos, and I will be back with a new one before you know it.